Both Callis and Machias, although the majority of it takes place out of Machias. Our business is somewhat dependent on transfer money. And the reason is that it is almost always insured. There's always some source of insurance. And because of its nature, it also adds up dollar-wise. So this is a difficult business. The busier we are, more havoc is taking place in a community. But at the same time, the more income we're pulling in. So it's one of those businesses where you're glad there are calls, but you're not glad there are calls. Without the calls, we would be out of business. So towards that end, we initially moved a crew to Machias to predominantly for transfers out of Machias Hospital. And I believe that we're averaging probably one a day, two a day at times, sometimes as many as three or four, not just from that hospital, but from Callis as well.
Before you were driving from all the way down to Woodland for a transfer, correct?
That's correct.
So well, it saves a lot of driving.
Right? Saves driving, saves mileage on the vehicles. The other thing that we're offering while we're up there is advanced life support. If you have an ambulance that does not have a paramedic on board and they have an emergency that requires a higher level of skill than what is riding on that ambulance, then they are obligated by state law to try to get a paramedic, right? And that's where we come in. We have a paramedic on duty up there, and they will get called to an emergency scene and do an assist. And as a result of that, obviously the benefit is that the patient's going to get better care, but we also are picking up some cash from that as well. Right? So initially we were doing 12-hour shifts up there. We're now on a 24-hour basis. I can tell you that in conjunction with Machias, we are doing an evaluation of all the bases to see where we're making money, where we're not making money. There are two that I'm particularly interested in. One is Danforth, the other is Machias. I want to make sure we're making money there, and if we are not, regretfully, I would pull those bases back. Because to my mind, obviously it's more important that the contributing communities are well taken care of. So that's basically it. I will add this, if God forbid, somebody from Lubeck is at the hospital and has to be transported, they have the right to pick what ambulance service takes them. If they're in Callis and somebody in Callis Hospital suggests Callis taking them, they should turn it down and call or down east, because it's their tax dollars that are supporting down east. And to continue that, the money from that call should be going to it, right?
It's one of the few instances where a taxpayer has control over where his tax dollars go.
Where your tax dollars are going. So, if
you're
in a hospital.
Well, there's a comfort level, too.
Right.
People you know.
Right. And odds are you're going to know
all these people from your community.
So if, God forbid again, somebody from Quebec or anybody listening in a town that is part of this, you're at the hospital, call for down east if they give you a choice. Right. And you do have a choice.
They tell you to be transferred somewhere, asked if they can use down east.
Right.
Thank you.
Thanks, Bill.
Keep up the good work.
Thanks. You too. You're hitting the guy I stood up.
Getting there.
Jeez. Yeah, you look good.
Thanks.
Next item, I wanted to discuss with the board some of the changes there that were proposed from Governor LePage. These changes that he's proposing will directly impact the money that Lubec received from the state of Maine. One of the things that he is proposing is eliminating revenue sharing, which town Lubec receives over $104,000. The homestead exemption for people under 65, capping general assistance on commercial vehicle registration. They're going to ask that we return that to the state. Sarah?
Do you still register commercial vehicles? Is that a possibility? We're no longer going to get the money back? Can we just stop doing the service?
Probably not.
No.
Can't, buddy?
No.
All right.
It's different agency altogether. Sarah? Vehicles have nothing to do with it.
How convenient we do the work and no longer get paid.
The excise tax would go to a different department altogether.
That's not the complete picture, though, is it?
No. Sarah produced a database, and the town of Lubec is looking to lose $153,869 in 2014 and $159,586 in 2015 under Governor LePage's proposed budget.
This is from the Portland Press, right?
Yeah. I've been talking to our representatives, Dave Burns and Catherine Cassidy, and really expressing to them that in a community such as Lubec, these cuts would have devastating consequences. Other areas that they're looking to cut is the retirement funding of teachers, putting more of that on the local communities instead of the Department of Education. So not only are our budgets looking to be impacted, but the possibility of the school budget. So I wanted to let the selectmen know, you know, as we get ready to go into budget season, this is stuff that we need to have in the back of our minds.
They're going to tax us out of the state, what they're doing.
No, they're not. They're going to tax you, but they're not going to give you anything in return for what you used to get.
And they're also looking at personal property tax, too.
Right. Yeah. Right. There was one more part to that, right? Excise tax.
Commercial vehicle.
Homestead exemption. The school.
And commercial vehicle. And then they're going to cap general assistance.
And they're going to cap general assistance.
Right. What's left?
Which is personal property.
Right.
And veterans exemption.
Comment from the public.
Yeah. Those same issues, not specifically, then probably will trickle down to the ambulance.
Yes.
It will. Yeah. It's going to impact everything. Yeah. We've initiated working closer with the school board. Their meetings will be here. At their last school board meeting, they moved to have their meetings here on Thursday night so that their procedures will be available to the public. And both boards have been working very close on this. It's a crucial time to pull the belt in and start maintaining an austerity line on this, because it's not going to get better, and we've got to make it work here in our little town.
And the school has to make it work, because the school budget impacts the town budget.
Absolutely.
And the superintendent is aware of that. He's making his board aware of it. And we seem to be establishing a pretty good relationship between the two boards, which can only be helpful.
Now, one idea I've been floating to some of the selectmen that I see is the Washington County delegation has a meeting on Wednesday nights in Augusta. It's at 7 p.m., I believe, and it's at Pat's Pizza. So I was wondering, you know,
we're gonna go ambush them.
Well, you got his attention.
would it make sense maybe for someday to announce to our delegation that we plan on going down? We plan on sitting down and talking to them and letting them know our opinions and our feelings on these issues.
I totally agree. I mean, you can send all the emails you like, but when a delegate from the town of Lubec shows, the delegation shows up, and it's like, well, here we are, we're real people, and we've got concerns and ideas about how to make it work, and...
And if you don't listen to us, your pizza's gonna go down hard.
Yeah. Won't you help, will somebody else soon?
Right.
I have to say that our delegation is good about listening to us, but it does not hurt, as Mike says, to be right there, to be in their face.
Squeaky wheel gets the grease.
Right.
I think that's sort of how it started out with the school board, and that's working out pretty well, so.
Right.
Let's try it with the delegation.
Email those dates, maybe?
Yeah.
But we're not the only town facing this, so we're not gonna be the only one putting up a fuss.
That's correct.
So it's gonna be a united effort.
Right.
Is there enough seating in the pizza joint?
I doubt it.
It's gonna be a popular place. I'm gonna have to reserve a table.
Wow. Oh, wow.
The times that we were there in the past, they will meet with you during the day, obviously.
Yeah.
And then they are very quick to invite you to go to that meeting in the evening. However, it can be, they can be occupied there with other things, so it's wise to give them notice that this is the day you're coming up.
Right.
Thank you. And I'm sure, you know, the selectmen that have jobs that may want to go, that may have to give notice, you know, this would be something that maybe we should be talking about, try to plan a day when as many people could go as possible.
Thank you, Bill, thank you.
We can do a school bus, we just try to pick up some chives, you know?
There you go.
Try to get everybody around.
If I miss a day of work to represent my town, I think that's the least I can do, because if I don't, what happens if I don't have a town to work in?
Right.
Nobody has any money. Another public comment.
Another public comment. If such a trip is actually scheduled, make sure you alert the press in time, that maybe the press can participate.
We certainly will.
Were you being diplomatic when you said the press, or you just want...
No, he wants pizza.
I want the pizza.
Fair enough.
Is there beer?
Yes.
That's pizza, it does serve adult beverages if you are of legal drinking age. See that?
All right, that's...
Sober driver.
Okay.
Next item, we discussed in the past some issues that we're having with the furnace. We had it looked at, and it was recommended that we look at an alternative. Apparently, we have nothing that's gonna happen immediately, but the furnace in the municipal building is getting tired.
And noisy.
During the work that we did with the Public Works Committee, looking at various heating sources, one of the companies that we come up with was a company called Pelletco. This is a Maine-based company out of Orono. Their sales is they will supply the furnace, they will supply the storage, and you buy the fuel from them.
How long is it? Was it locked in that we have to buy their stuff?
I believe
their equipment.
10 years.
But also include the information that we need to have a backup furnace in place. It's not that we're going to not replace this one and go with a pellet. We need to have a backup. That's part of the agreement.
They recommend, as part of the agreement, that we do have a backup system in place.
So the system we have now couldn't be the backup?
It could be,
and it may be able to be nursed along for a while longer before we have to... buy a new one.
Good thing is, if it was a backup, it would take a lot of the stress off, and we could start putting money away.
Exactly.
Right.
And the other thing, when I first read this over, I asked John, is there any way that we can request that it's only wood pellets from Maine? These guys are a Maine company. They're getting their wood from Maine.
They are. Their primary source are Maine pellets. And talking with the Mr. Knight, he said they do contract with some Canadian facilities.